All right, so here's just an illustration of what I was just describing, where you've got these wires. So you've got an appliance somewhere up in a kitchen, and you've got these wires that have got to go run all the way back. You've got to have walls in here and all kinds of stuff going on. As those wires get routed and make their way all the way back to the circuit breaker box down in some wet basement somewhere. So you're assuming that this ground wire is unbroken, that you've got a good bond here, that you actually have a good bond out here at the grounding rod. So they're very different things. They serve different purposes. And we're going to look at one of those when we talk about things like three-wire and four-wire hookups and the whole reason for doing that. So in the old school three-wire hookups, which are being deprecated now in favor of the four-wire hookups, this is for 240-volt appliances, obviously. We've got L1 and L2. So we know we're dealing with a 240-volt circuit here. There's also neutral. The controls could run off 120, so L1 to neutral typically. What were to happen if somehow one of the line wires internally were to break loose, or something broke loose on one of the loads and connected to the chassis, and at the same time, due to overload, loose connection, whatever, the neutral wire burned off. The circuit breaker didn't trip, but you've still got a charge standing on that chassis. So now you or the homeowner or somebody goes and touches that chassis, and you're standing in a puddle of water or something. Maybe you're touching a metal sink faucet. You've somehow got a path through your body to ground. Well, now you have completed a circuit. Your body now is becoming a load to a circuit, and you're going to have line voltage pushing some amount of current through your body. Yeah, that's why the whole idea with the four-wire hookups was to separate neutral and ground, recognizing that they serve very different functions. There's really no good electrical reason for ground and neutral to be tied together. They serve two different things. So now, in the case we just described, where you get a charged chassis in some scenario, the neutral wire burns off. Now, what's probably going to happen, since we do have a valid ground, and assuming it's connected all the way back to the circuit breaker box, now it's going to trip the breaker in all likelihood. That's what should happen. And so it's sort of redundant, but they really are functionally different wires. And if you come away with nothing, I want you to understand and come away with the idea that neutral and ground serve entirely different functions. Ground is not meant to be a current-carrying conductor. Only under fault conditions does the grounding wire carry current.